Nice. Rocky was his 2 out of 3 or so. That was a lot of one as one. They're gonna break it. Alright, what's up you guys? This is Devontae and
Deatra.
From the Just Right Family, of course, as you can see by our channel. But we just got through watching Black Panther. And I must say this movie was epic.
It really was.
Not just saying it. From like just the acting to the animation to just the storyline. One thing I really like about the story is that it stuck true to the comic in the overview in one movie. That makes sense. Like, so basically if you
don't know the comic, because I don't know, you can still watch it.
That's what I was about to say. So that's what made it great. It's like, even if you're not a comic fan or a Marvel fan, or if you've never really seen a comic, at the very beginning they give you a brief overview of what Black Panther is, how, you know, it's not just the Black Panther. They just basically give you an overview and they start the movie. And it was dope. One thing I thought it was pretty crazy, though, pretty dope about the movie, it was deeper than just the movie. It had like some pretty deep storylines, like...
Like they touched on some
real sensitive subjects.
Yeah.
Some subliminal, some just like outright in your face. Like, the acting was great. They had a heck of a cast. Michael B. Jordan did a great job. And it's weird because, not gonna give you a spoiler, but he was the bad guy, but you kind of found yourself siding with him. Depends. You'll see what
he was. He
was just extremist.
Yeah, he was doing too much.
You know what I learned? Like a lot of, throughout history, you know, a lot of evil people.
They have like a story behind.
Yeah, and they have good intentions, but they're so consumed with rage, it comes off different. So we're not gonna get a movie away, but
he was crazy.
Yeah, and man, when I say like, in my profession, what I do, like I have a lot of clients from like Nigeria, Ghana, like a lot of clients from the continent of Africa, you know? And like, so, you know, I'm pretty familiar with the culture. And like the way, you know, Wakanda is where it takes place. You know, it's a mythical place in Africa or whatever. Man, the culture there, it was very cultural, like. But if it's not, you never know. Like the movie, because the way the movie made it seem, you know.
I wouldn't be from Wakanda.
I wouldn't mind.
Or Canadian.
I would say Ghana or Nigeria.
Yeah, or Canadian.
She won't go to Canada. But things you need to know. Do not leave after the credits. 2 times. Not just one. So they'll do credits, then the song stops, and they'll give you something. And then they give you all the credits, make you stay for the end,
and then they give you something else,
which leads into the next Infinity War movie. If you're a Marvel fan, you know what I'm talking about. But yeah, so the movie, you really don't have to be a Marvel fan to stick to the guideline. It is
a really good movie.
Yes, at the end of the day, it's not one of them slow start movies. Like a lot of them were like, no bash into the Hulk, but the Hulk started like slow. You know, a lot of. You know, a few of the Avengers movies start slow to me, but this movie right here, it started off great.
Yeah, cause our showtime was 11:40 yes. p.m. and I was tired.
She was sleepy. She actually took a nap. We got the movie through that hour early. She took a nap in the car.
So if it would have started off slow, I would have probably fell asleep.
Yo, captivating. Look, the costumes were beautiful, from the main actors to like even just the cast, the villagers who lived in Wakanda. It was just dope.
What's it called? Armor? Those were dope.
Like, the weapons were dope. But of course, if you know about Marvel or Black Panther, the kingdom is known for vibranium. And like a lot of the technology is built off of vibranium. But man, like the way they, you know, put it into play, like it's, don't want to give too much of a movie away, but man, it's really, really good. I'm not gonna lie, like a few, like when they first start to like, get into some of the deeper plots, I'm not gonna tell you when. I was like outside of the movie, because they focus on the Black Panther movie and real life situations and how it incorporates to society. At first, I was like, oh, kind of got, I ain't gonna say uncomfortable, but it was a diverse crowd. So I was like, I'm looking around and seeing everybody else going. And then another one, without giving the movie away, they touched on Black American culture with African culture, the disconnect, and the way we need to connect. The movie was deep, like. It's amazing, like the way the king, you know, which is Black Panther, the way he played his role. I'm not gonna tell you, you guys will figure out everything, but it was deep. It was, you would think like a lot of Marvel movies, like they give you the backspin of the story, like for a brief overview, and then it gets straight action packed. This movie the whole way through, it was like intercultural struggles, and it was plots throughout the movie. It wasn't just fighting scenes, but the fighting scenes they did have, the fight scenes were, it was a fight scene in there, no sound, just fighting. You know what I'm talking about? Village, like, you know, because obviously Wakanda's it's a state-of-the-art, futuristic, ahead of its time type of village, hidden away in the mountains, backspin. I'm not giving you the witness. It's in the comics.
Let's get it with that dancing though.
The fight, you see what we're talking about. Everybody gonna be doing this. It's the new movie right here. Even the dudes, when he was mad, the second fight, back to the village was so state-of-the-art with the technology. Technological advances in movies, like you can tell the green screen work is kind of like cheesy sometimes. Mm-hmm. This was like legit. Yeah. This was like a real civilization city. Like how they didn't like focus too much of it on America, because obviously Black Panther is based in Wakanda in Africa. Mm-hmm. They kept the movie there. It wasn't like a lot of Western.
Yeah,
they was barely in America.
Like, they went to Korea, right? Was that Korea?
They did go to Korea. That's where they met. Okay, it was really in America for like a brief period, which I thought was dope. Like,
yeah.
A lot of movies get, if you read the comic, it gets taken away from the element, but not this one. Like, Wakanda was really like, they was bossing up.
Mm-hmm.
And man, when you see the technology, like, it makes me wonder, like,
what can we really do?
Because if this is just a movie suit you have to pick from, it's really, really, really cool. But the storyline, back to the storyline, the movie really had everything. It wasn't really missing much. It wasn't too long, which I prefer longer. Like,
well,
it was a 2-hour movie, but
yeah, it was like 2 hours.
I heard the original cut was like 4 hours, but they cut it down. And when you buy the DVD, you have the whole like missing.
You know what's crazy? I would take the 4-hour movie.
Me too.
Like, I would want to watch.
And she don't even like long movies like that.
Mm-hmm.
She don't even like action movies. She don't even like comic movies. She's a horror movie. It,
mm-hmm.
The Conjuring, but the movie was super, super dope.
Yeah.
So overall, I give the movie like a 10 out of 10. It's one of the greatest Marvel movies. But it's definitely one of the greatest movies I've seen, from the plot to the acting. A lot of the actors, the main actors, they're not, well, of course we are African descent, I believe, but they were like American actors who's from America. But my point is, everyone who's from America, who's American, the way they picked up on those African accents were like,
Oh, yeah, because Chadwick did a really good job.
He did, and I saw like a serious XM interview he did, like the study. They took it very serious. Like, and Michael B. Jordan got pretty swole for this movie. Like, I don't know if you ever seen him before.
Oh, I saw an interview where he said, like, he
social life.
He basically just worked out.
Yo, dude was swole. But overall, like I said, I give the movie like a 10 out of 10.
I do too. So, should you go see it?
Easy, yes. I'm going to see it again. We're going to see it again. I don't know if you guys heard of D-Box seats. We're gonna go see it, like the D-Box seats that move. We'll do a review on those too, but I'm definitely going to the movies again. I'm buying a couple copies. Yeah, so that pretty much wraps it up.
Yep.
We give it
10 out of 10.
5 thumbs up. If I had 5 thumbs, we got 4 thumbs up. 4 thumbs up, 10 out of 10. Movie's great, but make sure you stay after those credits to see the 2 tops.
Yeah, twice.
Twice.
To see the ending clips or scenes.
Yeah,
additional clips.
Please subscribe. Yeah, we really appreciate you watching the video. Hope you enjoyed the review. Leave us some comments. We're gonna do a lot more new movie reviews. We got the movie actually comes out today, but Blockbuster, I don't know what state you're in. It came out a day earlier, so we got to catch it.
Nice.
Rocky was just 2 out of 3 or so. Oh, I want this one. Inner Black Panther.
I won.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
I had rock.
Yeah, but my whatever I pick beats everything.
Scissors. Yeah, scissors.
Yeah, but it beats everything anyway. Like, I got Black Panther scissors.
So I hope you guys enjoy it. Stay tuned. Subscribe. Check out some vlogs. Hope you enjoy it. Hope you love it. Just Right Family. And we out.
It's this.
Yeah.
You're supposed to break it.
What did you dance to? They're gonna break it.